Introducing Thermo-Calc 2018A, released in March 2018. This release includes a new Python API called TCPython. This new API is an integral part of the ICME framework, allowing you to couple Thermo-Calc calculations with other software in an open way. The API was built in Python because it is a popular language which gives you access to many other programs, such as numerical packages like NumPy and SciPy, which can now be used in combination with our calculations. We are offering a free trial license of TCPython to all users with a valid maintenance and support subscription until the end of 2018, but you must contact us to request your free trial license. In this release, TCPython focuses on equilibrium calculations and the precipitation module TCPrisma. All of the precipitation calculations currently available in the precipitation module can now be run in this new API. This is the first Thermo-Calc API that allows users to make precipitation calculations. Users who do not have a precipitation module license can make calculations with up to 3 elements using the precipitation module demo included in your software. We will continue to expand TCPython and plan to offer step, map, and Scheil calculations, as well as diffusion calculations in the coming releases. TCPython uses Intellisense. The API guides users through the process of setting up a simulation, offering good values if you are unsure of what to set, and prompting you to include missing information, minimizing the occurrence of errors and making it an easy option even for those who do not have experience working with APIs. New examples are included in this API to help you learn about using the Python scripts and can be used as the basis for your own projects. To learn more about TCPython and request your free trial license, visit the Software Development Kits page on our website. In addition to the new API, the Precipitation module has several other improvements. It is now possible to enter an initial size distribution for each precipitate in a precipitation calculation. From the Precipitation calculator, select Show Details, then check the box next to Pre-existing Size Distribution and click Edit Particle Size Distribution. Users must enter volume fraction and composition of the precipitate. Starting values can, for example, be obtained from an equilibrium calculation. The program offers help in generating the size distribution by allowing you to choose from the distribution drop-down menu, or you can import them from a file. This new feature is demonstrated in graphical mode example P10. It is now possible to enter interfacial energy as a function of temperature and particle size. You can write any function that is an expression of T and R. A tooltip explains the new feature and directs you to a more detailed explanation. The new feature is also demonstrated in graphical mode example P11. The Diffusion module has two new features in Thermo-Calc 2018A, one in the console mode and one in the graphical mode. In the console mode, a new feature for automatic grid point distribution has been implemented. The use of the option Auto instead of, for example, Linear or Geometric in the Enter Grid command generates an appropriate grid at the start of the simulation. The grid points are automatically distributed based on the entered composition profiles and boundary conditions in combination with the kinetics of the system. This example calculation allows for a phase to form at the right boundary. The grid points are therefore more densely distributed close to this boundary and evenly spaced in the rest of the region where less change in concentration is expected. In the graphical mode of the diffusion module, you can now pause the program during a calculation, just as you can in the console mode. This allows you to visualize the results at various times in the calculation, as well as add time at the end of a calculation if you decide more time is needed. Learn more about this new feature in the online help by searching for Pause, Resume, and Cancel Diffusion Calculations. This release offers improved convergence for phases with charged species. This improvement makes it easier to do equilibrium step and map calculations for oxides. Three new databases are available in Thermo-Calc 2018A. TCHEA3 is a new high entropy alloys database which includes 6 new elements in this release, bringing it to a 26-element framework. The database contains more than 100 new binary systems and more than 150 new phases. This release offers the first kinetic database containing atomic mobility data for high entropy alloys, MOB-HEA-1, which was designed to be used in combination with TC-HEA-3. The database is suitable for simulation of diffusion-controlled phenomena using the add-on diffusion module and/or the add-on precipitation module. It can also be used together with all of the Thermo-Calc programming interfaces. MOB-HEA-1 includes 22 elements and 5 phases, as listed on the screen. A new version of our aluminum mobility database, MOB-AL-4, is now available. This database contains a new element, erbium, and an improved description of liquid. MOB-AL-4 has many updated and new binary systems and now includes ternary and quaternary descriptions. Thermo-Calc 2018A includes many improvements to usability and bug fixes, as well as several new examples. To read about these and all other updates, read the complete release notes available on our website at www.thermocalc.com.